Welcome aboard flight 248 to Tralee, and this is your captain speaking. I would like to thank you for flying Dyson Air, voted the airline that sucks the most. I know you have a lot of other choices when it comes to flying, but because you're so cheap, you're stuck with us. We are pleased to have some of the best flight attendants in the country working for this airline. Unfortunately, none of them were available today, however we do have Miss Dunn, Miss Over and Miss Under at your service today. Now normally when we have a stopover we stay in a hotel with bunk beds, so you'll often find that Over goes under Dunn, sometimes Under is Over Dunn, last night Dunn was under Over, and I usually finish up under Dunn. However, moving on, today's flight should last about 3 hours, but fortunately I know a bit of a shortcut, so we might be able to skim a bit of time off that. We'll be taking off basically as soon as I finish reading the flight instruction manual to fly this Boeing 737. Now, in the event that I need a bit of a nap on the way, don't worry, our co-pilot Nancy will be happy to take over. She's new to the job, but you have nothing to worry about. She has no compulsion about stopping to ask for directions if she gets lost on the way. Therefore, I'm now going to hand you over to Miss Dunn for the essential flight safety announcements. So relax and enjoy your flight in your incredibly uncomfortable seat. Thank you. Hello ladies and gentlemen, I'm your hostess for flight 248 to Tralee today. Now we're going to start with a safety announcement, so please pay good attention to what I'm going to say to you. Starting with the seatbelt. You must remember to position your seatbelt tight, low and across your hips, just like your grandmother wears her support bra. To fasten your seatbelt, simply take the end, insert it in the buckle and pull tight. But ask yourself, if you have to be told how to use a seatbelt, should you really be allowed out unsupervised? Now, as you were all boarding the plane this morning, I noticed a few ladies who had forgotten to put their makeup on. So for your convenience, we'll dim the cabin lights. There are two smoking sections aboard the aircraft today, and they are both located one outside each wing exit. We do have a movie showing, and today is Gone with the Wind. In the event of an emergency, you will be notified by the flight crew and myself running up and down the aisles screaming blue murder, but don't worry about a thing. In the event of the loss of cabin pressure, an oxygen mask will appear as if by magic from the ceiling. Simply put the straps over your head and try and breathe normally while we plummet at 500 mile an hour to the ground below. If you are travelling with a small child, make sure that you have got your oxygen mask on first and then assist them with theirs, like so. Breathe! What could possibly be simpler? In the event that we have to put down on water, and in the even more unlikely event that we survive doing so, then you will find that your seat cushion can also double up as a useful flotation device. Simply paddle to shore, where you may keep this with our compliments. Now I hope you have a pleasant flight today. Thank you for travelling with Dyson Air. Hello ladies and gentlemen, the captain has now informed me he's got the teensy-weensy little bit lost, so while we're going to go looking around for an airport, we're going to hang around in the sky for a little bit. So what I thought I would do is have a little bit of a sing-song to take your mind off the fact that we might run out of fuel and plummet down to the ground. This is a little ditty, so hope you all enjoy it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. We received an invitation in the post one Monday morn to attend our cousin's wedding in the town that we were born. The dew was back in Kerry, so wishing to be frugal, we're travelling it to find some decent travel deals on Google. Cheap flights, cheap as they can be. Bedad, we found an airline selling flights for 50p. Diddly-lied-and-died-and-died-and-died. Well, we clicked onto the website and were mightily surprised to find the actual cost wasn't quite as advertised. We'd forgotten airport taxes had also to be billed, but a bargain is a bargain, and begorra, we were thrilled. Cheap flights, stands to two Tralee. Ah, isn't every airline office flights for 50p. Diddly-eyed and died and died. After studying the website, we decided it was best to pay a priority boarding so that we'd sit two abreast. That's the best. And of course we both have baggage, so that's an extra cost. And then we're paid insurance in case our cases might get lost. Cheap flights, it's obvious to see. There must be extra charges when the flights are 50p. Minya, case change. At last the flight was booked. With all of the additions, we'd read the reams of small print of terms and conditions, and then we got the charge for using visa, which was drastic, cause how the feck is supposed to pay if not with feckin' plastic? Cheap flights were paid the feckin' fee, cause by now we were committed to the flights for 50p. Diddly-eyed and died, someone's been diddled and it's us, so it is. Our home. Now I don't know if you've tried locating Stansted on a map, but checking in at 5 a.m. is a feckin' load of crap. Here's a banjax if you try to catch a train or underground, and a taxi to the arse of the world is more than £100. Cheap flights, we should have gone by sea. There's no such feckin' thing as a feckin' flight for 50p. Feckity feck. Well, at last we reached the airport where we had to pay a fine. The feckin' feckers charged us cause we hadn't checked in online. And finally, aboard the flight there's an extra glass of tax, cause the feckin' feckers charged to use the jacks. Cheap flights, I think you must agree, to Tony fucking gobshite thinks this flight's for 50p. Feck shite, arse. The sad verse. Well, finally we landed and tried to shuffle up the aisle, but the steward sent us back to our seats with never a hint of a smile. And as we heard his announcement, our hearts gave a terrible dump. If you haven't prepared to use the steps, you'll have to fucking jump. Cheap flights, so hearken unto me. You're an idiot if you think a fucking flight is 50p. Feck! Ladies and gentlemen, our captain has now informed me that he has found an airport that he thinks might very well be Tralee, so in a few moments time we're going to attempt to land there. Therefore, can I ask that you put your seat into the most uncomfortable upright position you can find. Now, once we hit the ground, please remain sitting in your seats until Captain Braveheart and his crew in the magnificent flying machine come screeching to a halt at the airport gate. And once the tyre smoke has cleared and the warning bells have been silenced, then you can pick your way through the wreckage into the terminal building, and some of you might even be able to collect the bags you thought you'd got with you. Now, as you leave the plane, please feel free to leave any personal effects in the overhead lockers, because we are having a car boot sale this weekend and we're running short of stock. Thank you for travelling with Dyson Air, and we hope to see you again shortly.